Welcome back to the channel, YouTube. We are here in Palmetto, Georgia. Picking up a load of insulation. Yeah, that one. The fuzzy stuff you put in the walls. Picking up a load of that. It's gonna be a drop and hook and a live unload, and this is going up to Des Moines, Iowa. So, a nice long trip there. Deliver this. Today is Wednesday. Nice, there's my loaded trailer. So I gotta go around the back of the building, and it's got a green light, so it is ready to go. Today is Wednesday. This load will final Friday morning at 7 a.m. local time up there in Des Moines. Live unload, no big deal. It's only 13,000 pounds, which is nice. Another light load. It pays just over $2,700. So another 3+ mile load, and it's a light load, so that's always good, right? Gonna get this dropping hooked. I gotta drop my empty in Road W, like between 1 and 136. So go back here, find the W section, and yeah, drop this bad boy. This is a big facility. Oh, and I'm picking up in Des Moines at Vanderhegg's. They have a steering column that's already pulled out. I'm gonna pick that up. That's $200. So I'm gonna change that once I get up there. I'm hoping I can pick it up tomorrow before they close, if all works out. But if not, I will do it on like Thursday or something like that. So, or on Friday, I mean. Looking at all these little holes here, trying to find. This one will work. I'm gonna have to turn around here and swing in from the other side. I know it's a one way, but they'll be alright. I'm just dropping my trailer. I didn't like setting up from that other direction. They're gonna be mad at me. Why are you going this way? I can see the yard guy looking at me now. And they make you slide your tandems back before you even like come through the gate, which sucks, but makes things a little more interesting when it comes to backing up. But hey, that's all good. We're highly trained professionals here. I might get it in here in the second or third try, right? If I'm lucky. Just makes the pivot point when your tandems are all the way back. It makes it a lot harder to, or it's just not necessarily harder, but different. Like everything turns differently. Than if your tandems are all the way forward. So we are in the hole, but I need to straighten up, little soldier. So yeah, I'm gonna drop this thing and I'll hook up to my empty, and we will. Or hook up to my loaded. Jeez, I don't know what I'm doing today. People, help me. I need some help. I'm all confused. I don't know what it is. I guess I've had too much coffee today.
Jumping.
I do that at restaurants. The waitress will look at me like I'm freaking crazy. What is Java?
It's coffee. Give me some coffee. Bam! That's how you do it.
Except y'all didn't see how really bad it was because you could only see me and not out there. So it's a trick. I'm going to drop this and go get on my load. Like I've said already. Yeah, I've done that already. Seal put on. Should have showed you the actual load, but it's all the way up against the door. Everything looks good on the trailer, so we're gonna get on the road. And
almost fell.
Yeah, get on up there to Des Moines.
Des Moines, Iowa.
Iowa.
Corn. Isn't that Corn Huskers country or something like that?
I don't know, but. Let's go. We're wasting too much time.
Make sure tandems are in. Actually locked in the pins, and we are good. Forgot to write down the spot where I put my empty. I gotta go back and write that down so I can leave. Otherwise, they'll make me come back and get it, and I don't want to have to do this again. It's 13,000 pounds. It feels heavier than that, but. And 13,619. Down, get this number, slot number, job lot number, whatever the hell it is, and get on the big road. Catch up with y'all. Get on over here to the guard shed so you can check out of y'all. I gotta turn in my drop slip.
one copy?
Yep, thank you.
Bye.
That's a really nice lady. Very friendly. Very professional. Give her a shout out if I could. Our way to the big road, ladies and gents.
I just hurt myself. I stepped out of the truck. I stepped down here on the ground. And I went straight down on my ass.
Shaboop!
Oh, God. That hurt. I've never slipped on ice like that before while trucking. And I'll tell you what, that shit hurts. I don't know if y'all can see how much. That's straight ice. Oh. Whoa. See what I mean? This shit is slick as hell. Oh, pardon my language. My butt is a little sore. Oh, I gotta clear one of these chicken lights that are out. But trying to walk it off here a little bit. Whew. Oh, straight down on my ass. Anywho, I stayed at this McDonald's here in like Fairview, Illinois, just 9 miles from the state line. It was interesting getting in here. Let's see if I can show y'all what I'm talking about. I didn't record it last night because it was like almost 1 o'clock in the morning when I got in here, but I came up this road here and I had to pull up past the driveway back in because there's nowhere to turn around. So I wound up backing down to the end of the curb over there, and then I pulled forward, kind of lined up back into this hole, and it was hard to get up all this with the ice. It just kept spinning. So I finally locked into what I call four-wheel drive. Locked in the differential. I made it up a good ways. I could have went back another, I don't know, maybe like 8 or 9 feet, but it's all right. It was definitely interesting getting all that done, but yeah. I walked over to the gas station last night as well, a little BP, and got some gas for the generator. So I can run my heater. But yeah, I'm going to, I've already done my pre-trip, so I'm going to go ahead and get on the road and get on up there to Vanderhegst. They close at 5:30, so I'm trying to get up there before they close so I can get my steering column. And then I'll go to my delivery, drop my trailer. And then I'll like bobtail to like AutoZone or something and buy a steering wheel puller. So, do what we need to do there. And yeah, see y'all on the road. Watch out for the ice. Thank you. Alright guys, well I'm here, and I did go by Vanderhegs. I got a little tree branch scraping the truck. This place is freaking tight. Like, this is so ignorant. The only dock available for me to even turn around is this one right here. So I'm gonna blindside into there and turn around, and I'm just gonna back up down the side of the road, like, or the their driveway here. Cause this is freaking stupid. This is so terrible. But Vanderhegs didn't, they did have the steering column that I asked for. The problem is it has the same issue this one does. I was afraid of that, but there's another place in town here that does kind of the similar thing. You use truck parts, so I called them and he's supposed to call me back and let me know if they have one. So I'm hoping they do, and we'll go from there. Right now, I gotta do this thing. This is gonna suck. Basically, I'm trying to keep my tires in the tracks of the previous backer-upper. I know I can crank it tighter than that, so I'm gonna pull forward and adjust a little bit. I love power mirrors. Oh. Too tight. This is the fun part of the job. I've had to do stuff like this when you got 5-6 trucks waiting on you. You know, that kind of crap. It's very frustrating. Stressful.
It's all right. We'll get this done, right? Too sharp here. Still. Need to move over the angle a little bit. Problem is, I got all this damn snow over here. This is interesting, ladies and gentlemen. Goodness, I keep cranking it way too hard. I need to go in at a different angle here and do things just a hair different. More room back there than I think I do. Hell. Oh my goodness, I'm getting there. Crap. That was difficult AF. You know, the messed up part is, I don't know if this is their dock, so I can't exactly stay here. Back up back there onto the curb and park for the night. Not even the snow, it's the crap you have to deal with the snow. But I had to slide my tandem, so that's what took so long when I actually got in the dock. I slid them back more.
But as you guys seen, I'm sure. Oh, my bumper just, I need a tapered bumper, don't I? I just keep beating it up more. That's terrible. I'm gonna show y'all where I stopped at one point, and I'm like, something doesn't feel right. So I try to back up just a little bit more, and like just to kind of move a little bit to kind of figure out what the heck's going on. And I realized I was in this bad boy. Show you how deep that is. That's up to my top of my boot right here. God, that's a hell of a hole. I didn't even feel it. Didn't even feel me go up on there because I just rode up on the snow and then just sank in the hole. And I went back to there, to that point up there. And that's why I'm like, oh shit. So it wouldn't go back any further because the bumper caught the curb there. But it is what it is, I guess. At least it's not a new bumper. I just need to take the bumper off and I won't have any problems, right? I'm gonna see when I get home if I can't kind of straighten it out a little bit. Have the wife help me get it come along and see if we can't just pull it, replace the support straps, the metal straps that are on there that help keep it, the ends of the bumper straight out. So see if I can't just do something with that. But yeah, it's fun stuff. So I'm in the dock. They are starting to unload me. Later on today, I'm gonna go get a, well, after I hear from them about 8 o'clock, so right now it's 7. So once I hear from them about the steering column, I'm gonna go pick that up, as long as it doesn't have any play in it, because I went to Vanderhegg's, and like I said, it's got the same problem mine does. But mine's just steadily getting worse, so I need to get that taken care of immediately. But yeah, anywho. We're gonna have hats made to say anywho on them. Thank y'all for watching. I appreciate all the love and the support you guys have shown the channel. Don't give me too much crap about my bumper. I already know. My wife's already gonna beat my ass about it. Yeah, please like, share, subscribe if you haven't already. I know this is a little bit of a longer one. I try to show you guys everything I can as far as what we deal with out here on the road. Some of it's boring, but some of it is, I mean, like, back it in. Yeah, it's a long strip, or a long piece of film, I guess, of backing in, but I'm trying to get turned around yesterday. But I mean, that's the crap we deal with. Sometimes it takes 25 minutes to get turned around or whatever. So yeah, just want to show you guys and be honest with you guys. I'm not some super trucker out here. I'm just a regular dude that drives a classic, working at Landstar. And yeah, just, you know, try to keep it real out here with you guys. So let me know what you think. And as always, y'all don't have too much fun out there. You can follow me on Instagram at nomad.trucker. My wife is on Instagram as well at dino_princess_mom. If you guys haven't already, go check out Nomadic Brit. I'll leave a link to his videos in the description. He's a tanker owner operator for Schneider. It's got some great content. There's a lot of stuff I had no idea. You think our life is difficult or interesting. I mean, that's a whole nother ball game. but anyways, he's a good dude. Just trying to help him get his channel going a little more. So yeah, like, share, subscribe, and I will see you guys on the next one. Y'all stay safe out there.